Okay, then you click OK. Alright? And then they will tell you to protect whether the, some other protect sheet or protect document with a file name. So that will come under tools, protect document, and then you can select from here. Either sheet or document. Ni kena baca. So you refer back to your question. And then they will ask you to protect under password. So you key in the password sini. Go and go. Do you understand? And I will test, you know, whether you key in the password ke tidak. And please follow the casing. Kalau dia punya password Zuhri all in capital letter, make sure you key in all in capital letter. Because the minute I cannot unprotect kan, okay, that's where you will lose mark. Alright? Okay, that's it for protection. Okay, during you got to see the test. Yeah. So it can either sheet or document, does not matter. Eh, tapi kena baca soalan dia. Kena baca soalan. Are you okay?
Well, cikgu cuma ajar macam mana nak protect document macam mana sheet.
So you see, if you know this command, you will take less than 5 minutes to finish this question, really. So, baca, then perform the instructions. That's why I said your spreadsheet new question, I think 15 to 20 minutes, if you are very familiar with the command, you should be able to finish. Are you okay?
Alright.
Shall I continue? Just one last topic, eh? Okay. Okay. Don't worry about the text, eh? You don't have this. Okay. I never emailed you. Okay, but I'm just going to show you a demo. Shh. Okay, I'm going to show you a demo, eh? Alright. The next command is about columns. Columns, there's a little trick. Okay? Because the question will just ask you to do it in columns straight away. Okay? Columns based on the layout of the document you're going to get is exactly like this. Dia ada heading dengan the first paragraph. Macam ini. Okay. There's extra command lah about the heading. Ask you to format the heading. I will not tell you that because I think that is just to add on to the command. Now, before you do columns, you must do something else first. Can you remember what is that? Before or about columns, what do you do first?
Paragraph.
Huh?
Paragraph.
What must you do first?
Yang line tu apa
nama dia?
Okay.
What is it called?
That is the only one I did not ask for. Okay, so you kena ingat eh. What do you do? You tell me.
Mana dia? Section lah.
Okay. You need to create a section break eh. Okay, kalau tidak, what will happen eh? Because here then you need to do your columns, format columns. Okay, and I told you, baca soalan dia. Dia will tell you berapa kolom dia nak, sama ada dia nak garisan ke tidak. Okay, and how much spacing in between the two columns will be given there. Okay, so let's say they ask for two columns. The spacing between columns is here. And if you want the line, it will be here. Okay? And then you click OK. And there you go. These are the two columns. That's it. Okay. Ini pun kalau if you are very clear, trust me, you will, because you don't need to type anything. The document will be given to you. Because this is not a typing class. So I do not expect you to type. Cuma mail merge, you need to type from scratch. Okay? Alright, then that's it. Ada soalan tak? Do you have any question? So for columns, remember, put in the section break. The test will tell you, create how many columns, starting from which paragraph to which paragraph. Okay? Yang tu awak kena baca. Then create a section break. Dengar eh? So sekiranya, now section break is not, does not carry as many mark as creating a column. So sekiranya you got stuck there, aduh kat mana ni, this section tak tahu, as long as you know how to create the column, just create the column and then move on to the next question. Do not get stuck in that part. Boleh? House. Boleh?
Boleh.
Oh, okay, alright. With that, okay, saya isytiharkan kelas IT ni. Okay, berakhir di sini. Kecuali kalau ada soalan. Okay, in the meantime, okay, in the